fractions are usually less than one whole. These are called proper fractions. The numerator is smaller than the denominator. For example, 2/8 of a pizza or half of a sandwich. But fractions can be bigger than one whole. For example, here we have 3/2 of an orange. 1/2, 2/2, 3/2. You can see that 3/2 is larger than one whole because we have one whole orange and an extra half. 3/2 is an improper fraction. Improper fractions have a numerator larger than their denominator. An improper fraction can also be expressed as a mixed number. It's called a mixed number because it's a mix of a whole number and a fraction. How many wholes do we have? 1. How many extra halves do we have? 1. 1 whole and 1 half. The mixed number is 1 1/2. 1 1/2 is the same as 3/2. Let's take a look at another example. What fraction have these pizzas been cut into? That's right, quarters. Let's count how many quarters we have. 1/4, 2/4, 3/4, 4/4, 5/4, 6/4, 7/4, 8/4, 9/4. We have 9/4. This is an improper fraction because the numerator is larger than the denominator. Let's think about how we could write this as a mixed number. How many wholes are there? 2. How many extra quarters are there left? 1. The mixed number is 2 1/4. 2 1/4 is the same as 9/4. Here's another improper fraction. Let's convert this improper fraction to a mixed number. We are working with eighths. Our fraction has 10 of them. 1/8, 2/8, 3/8, 4/8, 5/8, 6/8, 7/8, 8/8. 8/8 is 1 whole. 9/8, 10/8. There is 1 whole and 2/8. The mixed number is 1 2/8. Here we have a mixed number. It's telling us that we have 3 whole and 2/3. How can we express this as an improper fraction? Easy. We count how many thirds we have altogether. We know that each whole has 3/3. So in total, we have 11/3. 11/3 is the same as 3 2/3. Converting between improper fractions and mixed numbers is easy. EasyTeaching.net